Hey guys, just wanted to show you my homemade 1.5 volt, 120 volt Joule thief. what it does is it takes a AA battery, it puts it through a transistor, a resistor, and this homemade hand wound transformer. It puts out about 130 volts AC current, and milliamp draw is pretty, there's not a lot of, I mean, it's, depending on what it is, usually, for the stuff I'm going to show you, it's about 100 milliamps, 120 milliamps. Nothing too impressive, but still, really, really cool. Oh, this is a dollar store super heavy duty Sunbeam AA battery. And I scrapped all the parts except for the battery holder, the battery obviously, this plug, and something else. Yeah, the wire. I scrapped all the electrical parts from an old television, including the transistor, the heatsink, the resistor, the toroid, and the switch. So, it's really simple. You have the hand-wound toroid. You have two strands on the bottom. You have two strands, first of 18 turns each. And then one end of each strand connects to the positive. Then one goes to the resistor, to the base, and then one goes to the collector. Then on top of that, I just, what happened was I found that this toroid, it was like this yellow half-inch toroid, I think some other person, a couple other people use the same exact yellow toroid with a white stripe that I'm using. It's like 1 inch by 3 1/8 an inch. What I do is I just wound 300 strands, or 300 turns of three separate strands of 30 gauge wire for a total of 300 turns. I connected the strands together. I just didn't want them wind 300 turns all at once. That'd be a heck of a long wire. So I just found 100 and then I cut it and I took a break. Then I soldered it, the two pieces together, wound another 100, so it's 200, took a break. Soldered the two pieces of wire together, another 100, so it's 300. And it's really cool. The secondary puts out about 120, 130 volts AC, maybe a little bit more high frequency, but if you put it like on your, maybe like on your arm, if you put the two ends on your arm, it does burn pretty badly. So yeah, that switch turns it on, and I'm going to show you a few things now of what I can do with the circuit. Alright, so right here I have a standard LED bulb. It's, the bulb is 0.5 watts. It's from Target. It's a little nightlight bulb. It has three SMD LEDs in it, and it lights up pretty bright. Don't know if you can read that there. It might be a little bit blurry. It says 120 volts, 0.5 watts, and 17 milliamps. So it's pretty bright, actually. So you just, all you do is you just screw it in like this to a regular nightlight holder, and you plug it in to the outlet. This outlet stinks, but make sure it's turned on. And here you go. You gotta see it. The lights here. It's really a, it lights up a workstation really nicely. I like this. I love this light. It's awesome. It's cooking at about 110, 120 milliamps there. Yeah, very, very nice light. Switch it off. Now, there's also something else I want to show you. Hang on a second. So here I have a strand of 60 LED Christmas lights. Let's get this out of here. There are 60 LED indoor Christmas lights. They light up okay. It's better with 3 volts, but I'm just going to show them 1.5 volts. See if I have it the correct way. Nope. Other way around. The polarity does matter on this. I'm not sure why, but here we go. Turn it off. See, they're lighting pretty good. You got greens, blues, yellows, golds, orange, and purples all in there. Six colors, 10 of each color, make 60. Alright, so we're right back. Now, I did make another JT with a different toroid, not this 1-inch toroid. That toroid that I made with made a lot of noise. I like this one because it's quieter, and it's really easier to use. So, hopefully this got you thinking on the possibilities of what you could build with one of these things, so go out and make one. And thanks for watching.